You have the results of the election committee court in the United States and the frauds of the Democrats was proven, and the result is that nor John Biden nor Donald Trump has the required votes majority of 270 votes. So in January it will go to the House to be voted there. So it is a spiritual battle going on between God and Satan. It is a wickedness in the heavenly places which is taking place, and the truth is being revealed of all the fraud. The prayers are working of the saints of God. We are still witnessing of God, and we still need to pray. So, yes, we are buying time. Time still to proclaim the gospel, and perhaps Donald Trump will be voted as president of the United States, and God is still giving time to unbelievers and believers who are living in the world to repent and to be a witness of God. And we have, how much more, I don't know, more time again before the rapture of the church. So we have that spiritual battle which is taking place in the heavenly places. So we must concentrate now on Ephesians 6 and taking on the armor of God, because we don't have to fight against flesh and blood, but against the principles, against the rulers in the heavenly places. So how do we fight? Well, we have given here the rules that we must take on the armor of God. And what is the armor of God? That is that we need to gird our loins with the truth. The fraud of the Democrats was revealed, and the truth of this fraud was revealed. So we must put on our loins with the truth. And what is the truth? The truth is the word of God. We must be honest in our walking, in our acting. We must be honest against our neighbor. We must be honest in our doings, in our acting. No private, no illegal copies. We must buy all legally, not without paying taxes. We must, our yes must be yes, our no must be no. When we tell something to a person, that must be the truth and not a lie. We must be acting truthfully in our walking, showing that we are Christians, respecting the laws of God, respecting the traffic rules. And we must put on the breastplate of righteousness, no deceit, no cheating, no bullying, no racism. We must treat everybody with respect, with love. Our first love is God, and our second love is our love for our neighbor. So no murder, no adultery, no theft, and so on. We must preach the gospel of peace, the gospel of the salvation through the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, that Jesus Christ died for our sins at the cross, that God wants to make peace with men, not to put him into the lake of fire. No, he sent his son to the earth, where Jesus Christ, his son, died at the cross for our sins. And after 3 days, Jesus Christ was lifted out of the death. The acceptance of God the Father for the punishment, but we need to accept that offer. That offer of peace, and if we reject it, the wrath of God remains on him or her. It is God who is offering peace, but if we reject, that's up to that person. But we need to walk to proclaim to our neighbors that peace offering. And above all, take the shield of faith. We need to have faith in the Bible, in the Word of God. We need to pray in faith. We need to proclaim the Word of God. We need to proclaim the belief that Jesus Christ is the only road to heaven. If we don't live under the control of the Holy Spirit, if we don't follow that narrow road, there is only staying behind, and there is no rapture for you to heaven. We need to pray in faith, and that is pleasing God. And with that faith, we can squeeze the flaming darts of the evil, of Satan, of demons. We can squeeze the flaming darts. Paulus is talking here about the flaming darts. The soldiers took peg, make the peg on the darts, on the arrow of the darts, they dipped it in peg, and put it on fire and they shoot to the walls on which were the soldiers. Also the soldiers in the field, and if they weren't protected by leather, the leather squeezed out the flames, they burned, the back burned on the skin, set fire to the soldier, and the soldier burned alive. It put on fire all what wood could burn. So they needed the shield of leather to squeeze out the flaming darts. And we are attacked daily by Satan with the flaming darts of Satan. And which are the flaming darts of Satan? Well, Satan is telling half lies, fraud, like the fraud at the elections, the fraud of the viruses, the fraud of the medicines against this virus, the fraud that the word of God is not the truth, the fraud when you are proclaiming the gospel to take the unbeliever away. Oh, I'm in a hurry, I don't have time. You are telling the gospel and giving that unbeliever hunger. I need to go to eat. Go with him. Go to a restaurant and continue your conversation and take care that that believer accepts Jesus Christ as his or her Savior. Proclaiming that the translation of the Bible is not correct, that the text in the basic text in Hebrew, in Greek, is different, that sin that isn't truth, that isn't that hard, God is forgiving, God is love, that doesn't exist, hell, that doesn't exist, lake of fire. But how does it come, all those adorers, worshippers of Satan? Why do those people in the church of Satan are seeing demons? Why is there so much misery, illness, all these viruses? That's a clear proof that Satan and demons exist, that evil exists. This fraud of the Democrats is also a clear proof that evil exists. And dishonesty, the flaming darts of taking away all the goods, all the best for the Americans. Look at Israel. Israel is blessed by God. Why do the countries wish to attack Israel? Because they wish the wealth of Israel, richness of minerals, of gas, of oil, this prosperity. Why are those countries around Israel, Saudi Arabia, the Emirates, African countries, Asian countries, they are turning and making peace with Israel because they know they depend for their peace against Iraq, Iran and Turkey. It is prayer which is necessary. We need to pray for the peace of Israel and Jerusalem. We need to pray for the welfare of Israel because it is God's people. We need to withstand the flaming darts of evil. We need to withstand all the lies. We need to take on the helmet of salvation. The helmet of salvation is the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. The Bible is telling the truth. Revelation is truth. The words and punishment of God about sin upon sin is true. We need to proclaim the word of God without turning it around, proclaiming it out of its context. We need to use the word of God when we are proclaiming the gospel. When Satan is attacking us with flaming darts, we need to take the Bible like Jesus did in his temptation after he lived 40 days in the desert. He said, it is written, it is written, it is written, who should only worship God the Father, not an angel, not a man, only God the Father you are allowed to worship. We need to be full of the Holy Spirit. We need to pray at all times, 24 hours per day. We need to pray. The Holy Spirit is giving us to lead us in the truth of the Bible, to lead us in prayer. And that can be on the street while you are driving, anywhere. You, of course, you have your quiet time in which you are concentrating yourself in prayer. But if you remember, I need to pray for him because he is an unbeliever. I need to pray for my brother, for the missionary, for the pastor. It can be 24 hours per day, in the night, during daytime, in the evening. Pray with perseverance, making supplications for all the saints. That's your brother, that is your sister, your pastor, the church leaders, the missionaries, the evangelists. We need to pray with perseverance. 24 hours a day, whenever the Holy Spirit brings it into our minds. We need to take on that armor which God has given us to be able to withstand against the flaming darts of Satan. Thank you, God the Father, Lord Jesus Christ, that you are clear in your word, that you have given us these verses in Ephesians 6, how we need to withstand and take on that armor, and what it means to be a witness, a testimony of you. Gird us with this armor and let us be proclaimers of your word, of the truth, and making peace. Because you are peace, the only peace, the true peace, which will bring salvation and eternal life in heaven. Open our eyes and guide us. In Jesus' name, amen.